Today we are going to see the edge coloring of a graph. K edge coloring tau of a loop plus graph G is an assignment of K colors 1, 2, 3 up to K to the edges of G. Just we assign the colors to the edges of G, it is called K edge coloring, that is denoted by tau. The proper edge coloring. Proper edge coloring means the coloring tau is said to be proper if no two adjacent edges have the same color. Figure G1, that is edges are adjacent edges, that is these two edges are adjacent, they are having different colors, black and red, and these two edges are adjacent, they are having different colors, and these two edges are adjacent, they are different. This is also a proper edge coloring because the adjacent material edges in this graph having different colors. In G2, that is in G2, these two are adjacent and these two are adjacent and these two are adjacent and these two are adjacent. They are having the proper edge coloring. But here these two edges are adjacent, but they receive the same color. Therefore, G3 has no proper edge coloring. Partition of an edge. An edge coloring tau can be considered as a partition E1, E2, etc. Ek of E, where each EI denote the subset of E assigned the color I. That is E1 with the set of all, the set E1 is the set of all edges which are colored by the color 1. And E2 is the set of all edges, the edges colored by the color second color 2. And EK means the set of all edges which are colored by the color K. Now consider this example. Consider this graph, that is E1, that is the colored by E1 A, G. That is A and G are colored by one color, E1 color 1, and E2 means that E and B, that is the edges E and B are colored by the color 2, and E3 is the colored by T and F, that is B and E edges are in E3, that is the edge D and F are colored by the color 3 and C is colored by the color 4. So it is now the edges at the total edges are A, B, C, D, E, F, G. They can be partitioned by the colors 1, 2, 3, 4. That is the edges colored by 1 is one set, the edges colored by the second color one set, the edges colored by the third color one set, and the edges colored by the color 4 is one set. That is, we have partitioned into the sets, four sets, that is E1, E2, E3, E4. That is, the set of all edges equal to union of these four sets, E1, E2, E3, union E4. And each EI intersection EJ equal to pi. That is, the partition of set is E1, EI intersection EJ equal to pi, when I not equal to J. If they have the same edges, it is not possible. Therefore, E1 equal to E1 intersection E2 always empty. Next, proper K edge coloring. A proper K edge coloring is the K edge coloring E1, E2, EK in which each subset E is a matching. That is independent, that each EA is independent, then that coloring is called proper KH coloring or set of independent edges. That is the above example, these four sets are independent sets. Therefore, it is a proper edge coloring. It is colored by four colors, therefore it is a 4-edge coloring. That is proper 4-edge coloring exists here. Next, K-edge colorable. A graph G is said to be K-edge colorable if G has the proper K-edge coloring. The above figure is 4-edge colorable, and this figure, these two adjacent edges have the same color, therefore it is not 3-edge colorable. Every loop plus graph G is epsilon-edge colorable. That is, 2 plus graph we have epsilon edges and each edge have different colors, then epsilon edge colorables. That is for by example, you see this example, all the edges are having different colors. So only we have 6 edges and 6 colors. Therefore, this graph is 6 colorable. That is 6 edge colorable means it is a proper coloring edges. Also, if a graph G is K edge colorable, it is also epsilon edge colorable for every K less than or equal to epsilon. That is K edge colorable means G can be colored by the proper K edge coloring, and also it is a proper coloring by epsilon edge coloring. That is example, here the graph is 3 edge colorable, that is block, this edge block, they are non-adjacent and they are adjacent, they are having the different colors. Therefore, we need minimum 3 colors. Therefore, the graph is 3 edge colorable. Now, recurring the above graph, that is here black, red, violet, white. Here we colored by the edges by 4 colors. Here the graph is set to 4 edge colorable. That is colorable, edge colorable means it only the proper coloring edges. We will see the edge chromatic number of a graph. That is edge chromatic number highlights. The minimum number of K such that G has K edge coloring is said to be edge chromatic number of G. It is denoted by highlights of G. The edge chromatic number, that is in other way, the edge chromatic number of G is the minimum number of colors required to color the edges of the graph by proper edge coloring. That is K edge coloring, that is the edge chromatic number of G is denoted by highlights of G. Now consider this graph G1. That is here we put highlights of G1 equal to 5. That is the here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 edges are adjacent. Definitely they receive the different colors. So W, white, yellow, green, black, red. So these 5 edges receive 5 colors and remaining colors R and BR, these 2 edges receive. This they are in different colors and they are in different colors. Therefore, highlights of G1 equal to 5. Now consider G2, that is here the maximum number, maximum degree of the vertex 3. So we need 3 colors R, G, B. And we put these two are adjacent, therefore we give black. So therefore highlights of G2 equal to 3. Here highlights of G3 equal to 3. Here we give the colors 1, 2, and 2 is not adjacent with 1, therefore we give 2, and 1 is not adjacent with 1, give color 1, and we cannot give 1 and we cannot give 2. Therefore, we give 3 and 2, and here that is we give 2. Therefore, the edges 1, 2, they are different, and 2, 1, they are different, and 3, 2, 3, they are different. Here, the edge 1, 2, 2. So we cannot give the color 2 here, so we give the color 3. And this is 2, this is 1, and this color is 1, 2, 2, 1, 3. So we cannot give the color 3 here, so we give the color 3, that is 1, this 2, that is 2 and 1, that is 2. Now 1, 2, 2, that is, this 1, this is 2, this is 2, this is 1, this is 2, that is 2, 3, that is, they are different, but here 2, 1, 1, 3, that is, here 1, 2, 3. So we are coloring now 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. here the edge 1 and 2, here 2 and 3, here 3 and 1, therefore radius of G1, G3 is 3. Any complete bipartite graph K, M, N, its chromatic number is maximum of M, N. If it is K, 2, 3, then radius of G3 equal to 3. Here A, M, N, the maximum of M, N is the chromatic number of the graph. Here definition KH chromatic, a graph G is said to be KH chromatic if radius of G equal to K. That is edge chromatic number denoted by radius and radius of G equal to K. Now in any proper edge coloring, edges incident with any one of the vectors must be assigned distinct colors. That is, edges must be incident with any vertex, it receives the different colors. That is, radius of G always greater than or equal to maximum degree of the graph. That is, maximum degree of the graph means the maximum number of edges incident on the vertex, maximum degree of the graph. Therefore, it receives the maximum number of colors. That is, maximum number of colors means that is maximum degree of the graph. We have maximum number of different distinct colors incident on the vertex. That is, you see the figure. Now this is the vertex which is the maximum degree. That is, it is a 5. That is 5. We receive the 5 distinct colors. And the remaining edges have the distinct colors. Delta equal to 5. That maximum degree of the graph, maximum degree of this graph is 2, 2, 2, 2, 5. That is, maximum degree of the graph is 5. Therefore, radius of G equal to 5. Also, consider this graph. The maximum degree of the vertex is 2. But here we give B and W different colors, but this is adjacent with these two edges, therefore we must give the different from B and W, therefore we have given R to this edge, therefore radius of G equal to 3. Find the chromatic number of the Peterson graph. That is, Peterson, the radius of Peterson graph is 4. That is, outer cycle we have 4 colors given, and inner cycle we have that is 3 colors, P, R, B, R, Y, 3 colors, and inner cycle also we have 3 colors. So in connecting the edges have only G. Therefore the edge chromatic number of the Peterson graph is 4. Edge chromatic number of the Peterson graph is 4. Next, a K edge coloring tau of G is given. Let us denote the number of distinct color represented at a vertex V of G by C of V. Consider this graph. Here we have proper coloring. That is, these two edges are adjacent. They have received the different colors, and these two are adjacent. They receive different colors. These two are adjacent. They receive different colors. So the coloring given by this graph is proper KH coloring. Here the vectors in V1 represented by two distinct colors, therefore C of V1 equal to 2. At V2 we represent two distinct colors, therefore C of V2 equal to 2. At V3 the colors represented, distinct colors represented at V3 is 2, therefore C of V3 is 2. The colors represented at V4 is 2, therefore C of V4 is 2. So C is a proper KH coloring, then the degree of the vertex V1, 2, and the proper coloring D of V equal to C of V1. Here, this is not proper KH coloring because C, V2 represent two colors same. And similarly, in V4, the two adjacent edges receive the same color. So, this is not a proper coloring. Here, C of V1, that is two distinct colors, C of V1, 2. In V2, distinct colors, that is only one color is represented at V2, C of V2 equal to 1, and V3, two distinct colors represented, C of V3 equal to 2, and V4, we have the only one color, C of V4 equal to 1. Therefore, C is a proper KH coloring, then D of V equal to C of V for all V belongs to G. Every vertex V in G If the proper KH coloring exists, then degree of the vertex equal to the colors represented at the vertex.